When you don't have enough, when you don't have food, when you don't have money, this is the right time that you seek God more. This, you know, it's nice to see God when there's nothing. There'll be a time when money is there now, you won't find time to see God. This is the time of building a level that you can maintain. This is, for example, let me give an example. You don't have enough now. You can study the Word of God together. You can pray together. You can share scriptures. You understand? There'll be a time, you know, you don't know that maybe God might be preparing you for big things. Whoever started big can go down. Whoever. You have to start small, to manage small. By the time when the everything is like small like this, you have got time to, you don't even have time to watch TV. You don't have, it's a time of going to throw yourself on your bed. You pray until you are tired. But if now there's everything, to be honest, I also regret this thing of every, this car, this house, this what, and one day you die, you live on here. I regret to see blessing in this world. They've really affected everyone. Once you've got now a suit now, you've got shoes now, when you want to talk now, your hand is here. Your hand is here now. Even when you walk, you walk like this now. You know? Even when you prepare the messages you want to prepare now, you prepare, you check. As somebody in America is preaching about this, somebody from Australia, you're no longer praying now. This is the time now of building a level. When money comes, must find you in that level. And don't go down from that level. The moment you are there, I've experienced what I know what I'm talking about. I'm not just talking about this. The moment when everything is there now, you'll be surprised that your soul is empty. Jesus, you just remember him. You find that, okay, money is here, everything. People are here, they want prayer. You don't have, they attack you, they do this. You don't know. This is the time now that your relationship with God must be perfect. When you don't have money, you remain the same. You same humble person. Money will come, you humble person. I mean, like you people, you know me. I've been here talking like this. You'll never find me doing like this. And because I've got money in my pocket, I'll never show, you know, or I come with a difficult speech that you won't understand when I preach. I'll preach the same way if God give me the grace, whatever, whatever. So let's maintain our level in the Lord before you maintain the level in the spirit. I'm sure you understand that. So whatever happened is to strengthen our spirit. Like now, if I'm losing people in the church, it's for my spirit. I was looking in your church there, Prophet Emmanuel, and I said, this is very good. People are not aware of you there.
Yes.
When you leave now, a problem. Normally you find that people are not aware of their pastors. They can't support their pastor, they can't do this. And others reject. When the pastors have got a big congregation that lives there, you find they are coming to sit there. This is the time now that when the church is small, you become serious with your pastor. You stand with him. It's hard, it's difficult to be close to a pastor who's very big. Either you go there with a wrong spirit, or you stand with your pastor until such time. So before the pastor becomes very big there, what will happen? Unali safe. It's not safe. What safe you are? Wrong people aside, right people aside. You will never have people you started a church with. You will never have people. You'll find that maybe it's one, and even that one backslide and come back. I'm just saying this so that you understand how church. You find that people are coming there, they will go, all of them. When they go, know that your church is breathing. Your church is doing what? It's breathing. So people must go, right people must come. Even like here, I can show you two or three people who are here. Other people are gone, others are here in zone. Others we leave them in zone 5 here. Here. Others insult, others say this. I mean, God is not with you. They are going to join other churches. When you see something, rejoice. When you see something, just do what? Rejoice. I'm referring to pastors. Let us not cry for members. Let us not cry for what? For members. Let them go. One person, when he goes, God is organizing 20. They will come there and support you. Let's not worry about these people.